Welcome to the National Poultry Technology Center's video education series. The topic for this video is three tips for maintaining tunnel wind speed in broiler houses.
It's well documented that hot summertime weather can be a great source of stress for commercial poultry operations. The value of keeping broilers cool and comfortable during periods of high temperature is well documented and well understood. Maintaining the effective cooling you get from tunnel wind speed and air temperature reduction you get from evaporative cooling systems is extremely important for maximizing bird performance in hot weather. To accomplish this, growers and farm managers should take every step possible to ensure their tunnel fans and evaporative cooling systems are operating properly and at full maximum capacity.
This chart shows data taken from Mississippi State's Dr. Barry Lott and his research showing the benefits of broiler weight gain grown at increased air velocities. This chart compares 4 through 7 week old broilers grown at 0 or still air, 400 feet per minute, and 600 feet per minute wind speeds. Notice that 7 week old broilers grown at 600 feet per minute wind speed weighed an average of 1/3 of a pound more than broilers grown at 400 feet per minute wind speed. This additional 1/3 of a pound in weight gain could show a grower an estimated $300 per flock in profit. Dirtier clogged evaporative cooling pads, dirty fan shutters, and worn fan belts and pulleys are common problems that can reduce tunnel airflow and cooling. In today's video, we'll examine these problems and look at some procedures often used to correct or improve them.
Clogged pads restrict air coming into the house and cause tunnel fans to work at an increased static pressure. The result is lower wind speed. Let's discuss how you can do some quick between the flock cleanings that will help maintain your best possible wind speed.
We must remove all foreign objects that could restrict the air flowing through the pads. This can be done by brushing the dried pads on the inside and outside with a medium bristle push broom. Once the dry matter is loosened, it can be blown from the pads with a high-powered backpack blower. A thorough cleaning of the entire cooling system by pad and cooling system manufacturer's recommendations must be done each year to extend the life of the system and ensure maximum airflow through the pads.
Just like dirty or clogged evaporative cooling pads, dust-covered fan shutters are major contributors to wind speed losses. Studies have shown that dirty shutters can reduce fan capacity by as much as 25%. That could equate to a 600 foot per minute house going down to a 450 foot per minute house.
This is a graph of a fan airflow performance curve taken at different static pressures. This shows an average difference of about 2,000 CFM in reduced airflow of a fan with dirty shutters compared to one with clean shutters.
Cleaning fan and shutters is a fairly simple job, but must be done between every flock and oftentimes should be done during a flock, particularly if in-house foggers are being used.
Keeping dust from accumulating on fans during hot weather can be done, but must be done carefully so not to damage the fan shutters or yourself in the process. We recommend doing a thorough cleaning of the fans between flocks with the fans off for safety. This video shows just how much dust can accumulate on a fan shutter during long hours of operation.
As we follow the path of air out of the house, we now must look at the fan itself. Keep in mind here that anything that would cause the fan to turn at a slower RPM rate than normal will result in less than rated airflow and therefore less wind speed. The primary culprit are worn or loose fan belts and worn pulleys.
New belts should ride high in the pulley with the top of the belt flush with the top of the pulley, much like the one in this picture. If a new fan belt rides low in the pulley, then you should check to make sure that the pulley isn't worn out and need to be replaced. Worn fan belts like the one in this picture can reduce a fan's airflow capacity by 15% or more. Just because a belt is tight doesn't mean that the fan is operating at its rated potential. Fan belts and pulleys must be carefully inspected between each flock and replaced if necessary.
Keeping evaporative cooling pads clean, keeping fan shutters dust-free, and maintaining fan belts and pulleys are three things that all have a major effect on wind speed and cooling in a tunnel house during hot weather. We hope this video has been helpful in showing you ways to maintain your cooling system and improve your ability to cool your birds this summer. Thank you for watching.
For more information, please visit our website, poultryhouse.com.